Good day, dear students. We are now at Polynomials, Chapter 6. In this video, we will be covering the second subtopic 6.2, Remainder Theorem, Factor Theorem, and Zeros of Polynomials. Let's look at our learning outcome for this subtopic. At the end of the lesson, students should be able to relate the remainder and factor theorem to solve problems, find the roots of the equations and the zeros of a polynomials. As in the remainder theorem, we can choose to find the remainder by using long division. Since the polynomial 3x to the power of 4 plus 5x to the power of 3 plus x plus 6 is divided by x minus 1, we can attempt to answer this question using long division. So the polynomial is 3x to the power of 4 plus 5x to the power of 3 plus x plus 6. And the divisor is x square minus 1. So if you remember, student, this is how we do long division. So to be able to find the answer, first we need to write the expression in this box, such that when it multiplies with x minus 1, we will be getting 3x to the power of 4. So we will be focusing on x square. So 3x square times x square, we will be getting 3x to the power of 4. And when 3x square times negative 1, we will be getting negative 3x square. So the term that we're going to write in our box here is 3x square, and when we multiply with x square minus 1, we will be getting 3x to the power of 4 minus 3x square, and we need to minus this. So 3x to the power of 4 minus 3x to the power of 4 will be giving us 0. 5x cubed minus, there is no x cubed here, so that means it will minus with 0. The next expression is x, but we have negative 3x square here, meaning the expression that gonna minus with negative 3x square will be 0x square. So 0 minus negative 3 will be giving us positive 3x square. And we're gonna write plus x plus 6 at the bottom here. Next, we're gonna find the next term. What multiplies x square minus 1 will be giving us 5x cubed. So we know we must be getting 5x cubed here. So obviously the answer is 5x. 5x times x square will be giving us 5x cubed. And 5x multiply negative 1 will be giving us negative 5x. So the expression that we're going to write in our box here is positive 5x. And when we multiply 5x with x square minus 1, we will be getting 5x cubed minus 5x. We're gonna minus this expression. 5x cubed minus x cubed, 5x cubed will be giving us 0. 3x square, there's nothing to minus, so we will be getting 3x square. X minus negative 5x will be giving us positive 6x followed by plus 6. Next, we're going to see what multiply with x square minus 1. That will give us 3x square. So obviously, the answer is 3. And when we multiply, we will be getting 3x square minus 3. So the expression that we're going to write here would be positive 3. And the answer here is 3x square minus 3. So when we minus this, we will be getting 6x plus 9. So remember, student, this question asks us to find the remainder. So the remainder here is 6x plus 9, which is the same answer that we obtain by using the remainder theorem. So you have second option how to find remainder, where you can use your long division. Now, let's look at our next subtopic, which is factor theorem. So, when PA equals to 0, then X minus A is a factor of PA. That means when we substitute with our divisor, and if we get 0, we can say that this is a factor. Okay, 0 here is the remainder. So once the remainder is 0, that means the divisor is a factor. In general, if ax plus b is a factor of px, then p of negative b over a equals to 0. Okay, now let's look at example 11. Determine whether the following linear functions are factors of the given polynomial. So we're going to start with example 11a. So if x minus 3 is a factor, then when we substitute 3, we should be getting 0 as the remainder. So let's see what happens when we substitute with 3. So we will be getting 3 minus 7 times 3 plus 5 times 3 to the power of 2 minus 4 times 3 to the power of 3. So we will be getting 3 minus 21 plus 3 square is 9 times 5 is 45 minus 3 to the power of 3 times 4 will be giving us 108. So when we calculate this, we get negative 81. So we know that P of 3 is not 0. Therefore, x minus 3 is not a factor. If we get the remainder 0, then only we can say that x minus 3 is a factor. Okay, students. Now, let's look at example 11b. Px equals to 2x cubed plus 3x squared minus 8x plus 3. So, we're going to find out if 2x minus 1 is a factor. So, if we want to find out that, we will be substituting the value of 1 over 2 into our polynomial, which is 2 times 1 over 2 to the power of 3 plus 3 times 1 over 2 to the power of 2 minus 8 times 1 over 2 plus 3. So, 2 times 1 over 2 to the power of 3 will be giving us 2 over 8. 3 times 1 over 2 to the power of 2 will be giving us 3 over 4 minus 8 times half is 4 plus 3. So, when we calculate this, we will be getting 0. Therefore, we can conclude that 2x minus 1 is a factor of px. Okay, students. This is because we get the remainder as 0. Now, let's try the last example on factor theorem, which is 11c. Px equals to x to the power of 4 minus 2x cubed plus 3x minus 6. And we're going to find out if x plus 1 is a factor. When we substitute p of negative 1 into our polynomial, we will be getting negative 1 power 4 minus 2 times negative 1 power 3 plus 3 times negative 1 minus 6. So we will be getting 1, negative 1 power 3 is negative, negative negative is positive 2 minus 3 minus 6. So this will be giving us 3 minus 9, which is negative 6, and this is not 0. So the conclusion here is x plus 1 is not a factor of px. We need to get 0 for it to be a factor. Okay, students, can you understand example 11? So this is how we do factor theorem. So students, I hope you have achieved our learning outcome, which is relate the remainder and the factor theorem. That's all for this video. Thank you, students.